Okay, now B, you're on audio. I need you to click the video. All right, praise the living God. How you doing today?
Good, how are you? Can you hear me?
I can hear you perfect. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Amen.
Thank you so much for
You're
taking my
welcome.
request. Oh my goodness, you don't know how hard it's been.
Well, you're the first one that I'm starting out with this new video Skype deliverance session, so you are the first. Praise the
Okay.
living God. But what I usually love to ask be, how did you find out about me?
Surfing the internet, just looking for deliverance ministries on YouTube. I saw you on YouTube. I saw some of your videos. I saved them. I saw your teaching that you had. It was a part one and part two. What else? What else? Oh, I went to your website and I looked through your website as well. So I just, it
Good,
was what I was
good.
looking for.
I love to hear people say that they look through the website because I have observed many people don't go through the website. If they would go through the website, they would see a lot of answers to questions that they have because I have so many
Yes.
messages up there, you know.
Well, I saw what I was needing help from, and of course, I'm sure there's more, but I saw one that you had posted, and I think it was 1 through 10. I think just like 1 through 9, I could have answered yes on them.
Yeah,
So.
that's now for all of you who are tuning in over the archive. What B is talking about are the survey questions. Okay, now it's 10 of them. I'm gonna call them out right quick. Now, if you experience, it don't matter how many. If you click yes or answer yes to any of these 10 questions, then that means that a spirit lover, a spirit husband, a spirit wife who is living in you and with you. I know some of you don't believe in spirit spouses, but you got to remember there's billions of demons. And demons are names are known by their responsibilities. So these demon responsibility is to destroy destinies in Christ Jesus. Starting from the child is when that person is a child through some type of molestation, these spirits will enter them. And then from that point on, you find yourself being attacked in various areas as pertaining to sex. But the survey question is, have you ever been molested? Have you ever been physically raped? It's by human beings. Have you ever been raped in your dreams? When you're raped in your dreams, these are spirit beings that is raping you in your dream, but you're having sex in your dreams, and some of you liking it. And you really don't realize you're liking demons, having sex with demons. It don't matter if they look like your husband or your wife. That is not your husband and wife. You have your husband and wife in the natural to be intimate with, not in your dreams. Do you have sexual lust? Have you had premarital sex? Do you have sex in your dream? Does it seem like you're being forced? Now, this is being forced to remain unmarried. Every relationship ends up in disappointment. There's a difference there. Do you masturbate? Do you watch pornography? Porno? Is there idolatry and/or witchcraft in your family lineage? So it doesn't matter if you answer yes to either one of these questions, it's evident that there's a spirit lover who is living in you and with you. And there's many born-again believers in Christ Jesus. They've never been delivered from those demons. And they're still living in the mind, the will, emotions, and the body. Now, one thing about Jesus Christ, he's not going to coexist with demons. Now, those, some of you who are tuning in now, you watch those paranormal shows, and you see how the psychics and the paranormal investigators teach the people to coexist with demons. Just live with them. They're not going to harm you. They want you to be their friend. There ain't nothing but one friendly ghost, and that is the Holy Ghost. He's the only friendly ghost. You keep that in mind. Any other
Exactly.
ghost, which is a spirit, they are evil. That's their nature. Their nature is evil. You cannot live and be at peace with them. So Jesus is not going to coexist with them. So he don't want us to coexist with them. Like he told me many years ago, I have some of you, Terry, but I don't have all of you. He had my spirit, but he didn't have my mind, my will, my emotions, and my body because those devils were living in those areas. So if you've never been delivered by a true anointed appointed servant of God to come against the strong man. You know, we got a lot of deliverance ministries who comes against the smaller demons, the foot soldiers. Demons on earth are known as the foot soldiers, you see. But when it comes down to the strong man, those principalities, that's where the problem comes in. The Lord said, unless you bind the strong man, you cannot spoil his good. So if you too want a deliverance session, a video Skype deliverance session, then just send me an email at exorcist@evangelistking.me, and I'll schedule a time and date with you to schedule your session as I did B. Praise the living God. Now, B, just share with us, based on the things you heard me say in my messages in deliverance sessions, what you have been going through. And you realize, hey, you know, this has happened to me. I need to be delivered. Okay, now for some reason, B, I can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now, yeah.
Okay. Basically, just bombarded with thoughts. People have been seeing me dressed very provocatively, and I'm fully clothed.
Wait a minute now. Hold on. Let me stop you there for a moment. So in other words, when you put your clothes on, you're fully clothed. You're not exposing your cleavage. You're not showing the shape of your body. But when other people look at you, they see snake. You know that's
is it? Is that what it's
snake? That spirit snake.
Wow, I did not know that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So where does that come from?
They are known as sexual demons. They come in a bundle. Lord told me it comes in a bundle. Now, I use a lot of computer software. And I love bundles because you get a special price when it's, when it's a bundle. Well, that's how sexual demons are. When you get one sexual demon, you got them all. So you got spirit spouses, which is spirit husband, spirit wife. They always work with Jezebel. The spirit snake, that is lust. Spirit snake, that's what causes a woman and man feel that they got to dress sexy. And they want to feel sexy, that sexy feeling. That's spirit snake. You got bestiality. Mm-hmm. Bestiality, you got homosexuality, you got lesbianism. All of those spirits are known as sexual demons, and it's a bundle. So when you get one, you got them all.
Okay.
That's how they secure their stay. You know, you rarely find a demon living in a human host by themselves. They always open the door to let others in because they like to secure their stay. So that's what people were seeing, B. They were seeing spirit snake. Now, when people would tell you that, what did you say to them in reference to your dressing?
Actually, I really didn't say anything to them. I was just like, I was in shock. Because I can be in a room of four or five people. Maybe two or three will see it. The others just won't. So I didn't know what to tell them, but I knew that there was something there because it's been going on for such a long time, and I've been through self-deliverance. So I have also been through other just deliverance sessions that I've found on the internet or not with other people, but just teachings. And I have gotten rid of some stuff, but this is kind of like this is the hard one.
That's the strong man. That's where you need help. And just not
yes.
need help. You need an anointed, an appointed servant of God.
And not only that,
it
makes a difference when you know, when you understand where the person is coming from, because some people didn't understand it.
No. You know, a lot of deliverance ministers, they really go out before their time, to be quite honest with you, because they would try many, many years to get me to go out before my time, but praise God, I never did that. I waited on the Lord. So what they usually do, they go by what you tell them. You know, they listen to you, and they listen to whatever spirit you say you're dealing with, that's the spirit they will target. But that's wrong. You don't do that. You go by what the Holy Spirit tell you, because the Lord said, unless you bind a strong man, you cannot spoil his good. David, when he fought, he did not go after those little soldiers. He went after Goliath. That's who the little soldiers were depending on, the strength of Goliath. He knew when he killed Goliath, those other little soldiers were scattered because their strength was gone, you see. So the strong man is spirit husband and also self-deliverance. Self-deliverance is not a pre-deliverance. It's a post-deliverance. It's not what we do before we get delivered. It's what we do after we get delivered. But ministers have taught people that you could do self-deliverance on your own, and you don't need no one to help you. No, self-deliverance is a post-deliverance, not a pre-deliverance. You got to get delivered, totally delivered from that strong man first. Then after you get delivered, then you be taught how to maintain your deliverance. That's what self-deliverance is. It's maintaining your deliverance. It's things that you do to maintain. According to James 4:7, submit to God. And by submitting God, you'll be able to resist the devil's temptation, and the devil will flee from you. Okay? So that's what self-deliverance is, you see. But when it comes down to a strong man, you need help. Lord, no, I needed help. Oh, I loved him. I had a relationship with him. But those spirits were living in my soul area and in my body. And the Lord did not want me to be separated from him. So he sent me to my human helper. And when he did, that woman cast that strong man out of me. You see, I worshiped him. My mind was stayed on him. But those spirits were still in my soul area and still in my body. I needed a human helper, the one that Jesus Christ chose to help me. And another problem is people try to choose their helper. You don't choose your helper.
Yeah.
Jesus chooses your helper. You see, you ask the Lord to lead you to your human helper, and which he did be. You will get totally free. Now, again, after you're free, you are truly free. I mean, there's nothing I can really say to convince you that you are free. You are free. Jesus is gonna take his, not even when you thump something, he's gonna thump that strong man right on out.
Amen.
He's going to do that. But you know what, B, you have to believe that he did that.
Exactly.
For what I've come to see, that the devil always uses his twins of darkness, who is unbelief and doubt, and get the person to doubt. And those devils were accusing your hearing. Oh, how do you know you deliver? You're not deliver. Did you see anything? Did you feel anything? See, that's a lie right there, because it's not in what you feel. Even if you do feel something, it's still not in your feeling. That is not your evidence or your substance that God set you free. It's your faith in his word that he set you free. Understand? Because the devil is a great illusionist being. He will give you an illusion. His illusion is he'll make you feel something crawling on you, and he'll tell you, oh, that snake is still in you. You get what I'm saying? You have to rebuke him. Say, no, I know I'm free. Jesus loves me. Matter of fact, he died for my freedom, and I believe his word. I'm not a carnal Christian. I don't walk by sight. I don't walk by feeling. I walk by faith in his word. He did it. Praise the living God.
And amen.
Comes from you. So this is self-deliverance. Maintain your deliverance. Because the devil going to try everything in his power to try to get you back. You know, I mean, when he try to get you back, it's going to seem like the attacks are so strong. They're stronger than it was when you first contacted me. You should praise the Lord. It's a good sign. Because the devil really trying to get you back. That means he's not in there. I mean, if he already got you, why are he going to try to fight so hard to keep you when he already got you? No. When the Lord casts him out, that's when he turns up the heat in his attacks. So you have to believe. Don't go by your feel. Again, the Lord will sometimes let you feel. He will. But you don't go by your feeling. That's not your evidence that he set you free. You know, when he set me free, he let me feel. But that was not my evidence. My evidence was my faith in his word. Faith in his word. That's the only thing that pleased him. If it's not a faith, it's sin. And sin is going to reopen that door. So now, B, have you ever seen this spirit in your dreams or seen it around your house?
No.
Never. It never made itself known.
No. What happened was, what I have been noticing is, in May, I bought a brand new home, brand spanking new home. Within a week after moving here, I started to feel a sensation in my bed, moving from the foot up to the head of the bed, from the foot up to the head of the bed, back and forth, back and forth. And at first I was like, okay, I don't know what this is, whatever. But then more and more, I was like, it hasn't gone away. And I just didn't understand that, because the house is brand new. I know the house is not haunted.
Where did the bed come from?
The mattress is brand new. I bought it at the furniture store, and I make sure that it didn't have any symbols or, you know, anything that, you know, it's just.
And also the bed frame.
The bed frame is good. Yeah, it's all new. But anyway, I was wondering if this isn't part of it.
But I'm trying to figure out, why did it wait? It's always been there. But I'm trying to figure out, waiting on the Lord to tell me, why did it wait then to manifest itself in that new house?
I don't know, because when I was living in the other house, the warfare was different there than it is here. Here, it's like it has been escalated when I moved to this town. But
did you check the history of that land? Check the history of the land that the house is built on.
No, I didn't check it. I was here when the house was being built, in the process of it being built, because I got to see it, you know, from the ground up. But we did stake the land with scriptures, and I anointed it. I walked the property. Mm-hmm. I prayed over it. And that's what I encountered.
To your recollection, did anyone ever sit on that bed? On your bed?
No. That's always been my... The mattresses, I've only had the mattresses like 1 year. So they're pretty new. And the only people who moved the bed were the movers, because I hired a moving company to help me move.
The movers. When they moved the mattresses in, did you pray over it?
No.
You didn't, did you? Yeah, dear heart. Pray over everything. Because you just don't know these days what people are into. A lot of times that they are into devil worship. And they know all they have to do is just speak a curse and touch something and speak a curse. It will leave the imprint of a demonic spirit.
Okay.
And a lot of times we Christians, we are so careless, we think nothing of it. And next thing you know, we are experiencing paranormal activity. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so whatever you bring, and like the Lord told my daughter, that she goes out and buy clothes for her child, for herself. And one day she brought some clothes home and she started being tormented by the enemy, and she was like, "What is going on?" And she asked the Lord. Lord told her, "Say you forgot to pray over those clothes, because you got to realize when you go out and buy clothes, people's hands are touching it. They go touch it, they try it on, or just merely touching it. And devil worshippers, again, they do be speaking curses. And by us being careless, we think that nothing we bring home, then we start being tormented."
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I do keep praise and worship music in my bedroom, the living room, you know, throughout the house real softly, even throughout the night. I'll put on scriptures on CD. Mm-hmm. I'm good about praying early in the morning, late in the evening, just throughout the day. So
you keep doing that. You continue to do that. Right now, that spirit husband is in there as well, the spirit snake. And Jezebel is there too, because they always come together.
Okay.
They come together. You know, Jezebel's against authority. You know, not so much as a woman against a man. No, it's authority, period. Jezebel's against authority. A lot of times people have supervisors giving them a specific or direct order, and they get angry because they think they have a better suggestion, and they get angry. Be careful, because Jezebel will enter you, because you're going against authority. Especially when that authority is not teaching you to come against God. You see, that's that spirit of Jezebel. Okay? But again, be God going to set you totally free. So you have to continue to maintain. Now, are you married at the moment and living with your husband?
No, I never been married.
No, you never been married. That thing wouldn't even let you get married. So are you in any type of relationship?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
I never have been. Probably the last relationship I was in was when I was in my early 20s.
Okay. So continue to keep your eyes and mind fits on the Lord.
Yes.
Keep your eyes and mind fits on the Lord. You know, if it's God's will, then he will send someone. But I wouldn't advise go out looking.
Because oh, no.
Devil
no.
Put the wrong man in your
path.
No.
Right now, I have no interest in, you know, I'm just not looking. So
I don't blame you, sister. I do not blame you whatsoever. You know, we need to learn to fix our mind and heart, stay on the Lord, and give that care. Just cast that care on him and let him take care of it. Meantime, we continue to stay fixed on him. So you've done all your spiritual house cleaning. You know, hear that teaching about your spiritual house cleaning.
I'm pretty good about that, yes. I'm pretty good about doing spiritual house cleaning.
Okay.
I don't have any objects. At least I don't feel like I do, because I got rid of a lot of stuff. Plus, I've read some books on spiritual house cleaning, you know, clearing the land, whatever. So
good, great. All right. So what I'm going to do now, B, I'm going to pray for you. And then I'm going to confront the spirit husband and every spirit, not a Holy Spirit, to come out of God's house, because you are
Amen.
God's property. You know,
yes.
really don't have no more legal right to stay. You don't have a legal right.
I agree.
It's trespassing. But since it's never been confronted and commanded to leave, because demons just don't leave voluntarily.
Mm-hmm.
You have to command them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to leave, and then they leave. Okay? So I'm going to pray for you first in Jesus' name. So, Father, as always, in Jesus' name, I just thank you for this opportunity you have given me to minister your loving grace and mercy to your dear daughter, B. Father, I thank you that you refuse to allow B to remain as is. For you said that there would be no speck of darkness entering into your kingdom. And your desire is for B to be where you are through your son Jesus by his spirit. Father, I thank you for keeping her. Keeping her, Father, thus far. Keeping her, Father. Thank you for sealing her with your spirit, Lord. Thank you, Father, for every plan and purpose and idea that you have for her. It shall come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for raising her up to be a mighty example, a woman of God. So when people look on her this time, Father, they will see her clothes in righteousness, fully clothed in righteousness,
yes,
the righteousness
Lord.
Of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, where men shall be drawn to you through her, Father. And I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I speak concerning doors with the enemy, have sealed and closed off to be, and it's your will for those doors to be open. I take my thoughts in Jesus' name, and I open every door that is your will to be open. And I also close the doors that the enemy have opened that was never your will. I close those doors and seal those doors in and with the blood of Jesus, where they never be opened or reopened again. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the angels right now that you got around her, encompass around her, Father, protecting her 24/7, Lord. Thank you for the angels you've got encamped around her property, Father, Lincoln angels that you have encamped around her property. Thank you for keeping her, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, you said in your word that when just two of us come together in your son's name, you are right here in the midst with us. And whatever we bind and loose on this earth, Father, you bind and you loose us into heaven. So right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, spirit husband, come to attention. Come to attention. Come to attention in Jesus' name, for the blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you. Come to attention. Gather all your things. Pack your loads. Pack your loads and get out of God's house. Get out. 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 For the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus command you over 2,000 years ago to get all this out. You come out of her mind. Loose her mind. Loose her mind. Loose her mind. Cut her mind. Out. Gather your loads and get out. Get out of her mind. Get out. Take everything that belongs to you and get out. For the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus commands you. Come out of her mind. Out of her mind. Out. All of you out. In Jesus' mighty name. You turn loose her will. Turn it loose. Turn loose her will. Turn loose her will. Turn it loose. Turn loose her will. For the blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you. Turn loose her will. Turn it loose. Turn it loose. And get your things. Get all your things and get out of her emotions. Cut her emotions. All of you out. Out of her emotions. Out of her emotions. For the blood of Jesus. You see this? The blood of Jesus commands you. Cut out. Out. Out of her emotions. Out. All of you. Cut out. Out. Out of her emotions. In Jesus' name. And you definitely get out of her body. Get out, spirit snake. Out. Out, spirit snake. Out. Out, spirit snake. Jezebel. Get out. Get out them things that belongs to you. Everything that belongs to you and get out. For the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus commands you. Out. Out. Holy Ghost. Sick them. Holy Ghost, set them all ablaze. Burn every spirit that's dominant trying to hold to on be in a mind. Set them ablaze. Seek and destroy everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God and set ablaze. Holy Ghost, fire burn. Burn all manner of darkness in the mind. Go deep, deep down into the memory, the subconscious of a mind. Burn everything that's not of you. Destroy every image, every picture that's not of you. Set ablaze. Set ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn. Burn everything that's not of you. Ransack her mind by your consuming fire. Ransack her mind, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, fire even burn. Burn in her will. Burn every spirit that's dormant trying to hold on to her will. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, burn in her will. Even in her emotion. Just ransack her emotion. By your consuming fire. Everything that's not of you, Holy Ghost, in her emotion, set ablaze. Set ablaze. Set ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn. 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 Burn everything that's not of you. Burn darkness that's trying to clench and hold onto her body. Set her body ablaze by your consuming fire. Burn, Holy Ghost, just ransack her body from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Destroy that evil garment on her body. Burn those evil garments. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn those evil garments. Burn snakes that come up loose out through the window of her eyes. Burn around her eyes, the front, the back, and the sides of her eyes. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn up and down her nostrils. Burn darkness that even holding onto in her nostrils. Burn them spirits in her nostrils. Burn! Burn, Holy Ghost, even in her ears. Burn darkness hiding in her ears, even in her mouth. Set her mouth ablaze. Burn even up and down her throat. Set darkness ablaze that trying to hold into her throat. Burn, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire even burn in her belly. Go deep, deep down in her belly. Burn every dormant spirit that's hiding in her belly. Every animal spirit, every insect spirit, marine kingdom spirit, spirits that take on human appearance and form. Burn animal spirits. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set them all ablaze, Holy Spirit. Even in her vagina. Set a vagina ablaze. Burn every spirit that even hide in her vagina. Set it ablaze. Set it ablaze. Even in her rectum. Set a rectum ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn in her uterus. Burn in her fallopian tube. Burn in her womb. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Everything that's not of you, just set it ablaze. Set it ablaze. Burn up and down her arms. Up and down her lid. Burn on her fingers. Burn on her toes. Burn that evil crown on her head. Burn, Holy Ghost. Around her neck, burn around her head, around her ankles, around her feet. Burn, Holy Ghost, every change of darkness, burn, destroyed by your mighty consuming fire. burn, Holy Ghost, just ran Shekabot, burn every mark known or unknown to her on her body. Destroy those evil marks, Holy Ghost. Burn every piercing that was punctured in her, in and on her body, known or unknown to her. Destroy those evil piercing in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, baptize her body. Baptize her body. Wash her body. Clean her body. Redeem her body. Purify her body. Ransom her body. And baptize her body in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. In the spirit realm, in the name of Jesus, I take the scissors of God. I cut and detach his bead from the ungodly covenant of idolatry and family witchcraft. I detach her because the blood of Jesus detached her over 2,000 years ago. I detach her from every relationship in the spirit realm my heavenly Father did not connect her to. I disconnect her. I disconnect her from the evil spirit husband, the evil spirit wife, all those evil spirit children, the entire evil spirit family. I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnect her. I disconnect her from that evil spirit marriage in the name of Jesus, for the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free by his shed blood. Even in the natural realm, every relationship my heavenly Father did not connect her to, I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnect her and set her totally free in Jesus' mighty name. Sister B, in the mighty name of Jesus, be free. Be totally free in your mind to serve the Lord. Be totally free in your will to serve the Lord. Be totally free in your emotions to serve the Lord. Be totally free in your dreams to serve the Lord. Be free in your vision, in your businesses, in your family, and be totally free in your body to serve and worship the Lord. Him only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' mighty name. Be free.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now, Father, fill your daughter. Fill your daughter to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind to overflow. Fill her will to overflow. Fill her emotions to overflow. Fill her dreams, her vision, her business, her affairs to overflow with your spirit. And fill her body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Also, Father, I pray for my sister's house. Holy Ghost, sick them. Seek and destroy all manner of spirits that is dormantly lurking and hiding in every corner, crack, and crevice of the house. Destroy by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost, fire, sick them. Go in every room and every bedroom and destroy darkness. Darkness who is around the bed, over the bed, the front, the foot of the bed, under the bed, even on top of the bed, in between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy darkness. Don't leave no hiding place. Holy Ghost, sick them. Burn darkness and even hide between the walls. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every object that was planted between the walls, that were planted under the floor, in the ceiling, behind the walls. Destroy those evil objects. Holy Ghost, sick them. Seek and destroy everything that lifts itself up against the standards of God. Yes. Holy Ghost, go even outside of her house. Destroy thought that who's around the house. Under the house, over the house. Thank you, even Father. Under the ground, under the house, and destroy darkness. Holy Ghost, sick them. Seek and destroy darkness. Destroy darkness, every curse, every covenant, every contract against her and her family. That was written on top of the earth. Thank you, that were written under the earth and even under the water. Destroy those such contracts and covenants and agreements by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost, sick them. Destroy every evil object that was placed in her name, her feminine name, on top of the earth. That was buried under the earth. That was cast in the sea. Destroy those evil objects. Seek and destroy those evil objects in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for your angels. Dispatching your angels and grabbing every spirit that was not of you and sending them where you desire to send them in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for setting this captive totally free.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father, for your mercy, your kindness, and your goodness. in Jesus' name. In Jesus. And give my sister sweet sleep, peaceful sleep, peaceful rest. Yes. Just let your presence, practice of your presence show throughout her house, even outside the house. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Amen. Amen. Amen, sister. It's done in Jesus' mighty name. It is done.
My body feels good.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to his holy name. Thank
Praise
you,
Lord. Praise God.
Amen. You are totally free. Jesus. And what that means, Sister B, being free means devil are not living in you.
Amen.
They're not living inside of you. They're not in your mind no more. They're not in your will no more. They're not in your emotions. They're not in your body no more. They're not in you no more. Now they're on the outside. That's where they should be.
Amen.
That's where they should be. Yes. The battle should not be raging on the inside of us, God's children. But the battle always raging on the outside. Mm-hmm. So as we trust the Lord, the Lord said the battle is his. That battle is his. See, God freed us for one reason, and that is to worship him. We're free to worship him.
Yes.
In the beauty of his holiness. That's why he freed us. So you are free. So you praise him, you thank him. So don't believe the lying devil and telling you that you're not free.
Amen.
That's just a lie, because you are. I mean, Jesus said, remind me of my word. He said, whatever you bind on earth, I'll bind in heaven. So we have to decree it on earth, and God does it in the heavens. I believe his word, and he does it.
Yes.
You know? And Satan, no, I don't have to see to believe. I don't have to feel to believe. And Lord have raised me and taught me to believe him without feeling and to believe him without seeing. I believe his word.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
You praise him.
Praise God.
Thank you. So just share with us, Sister B, what you were experiencing as the fire prayers was going forth.
My body was tingling. The top, my back, towards the front. My arms, I felt like a heaviness, real heaviness.
Mm-hmm.
And as you were calling him out, I got real bad, I shouldn't say real bad, real strong chills.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kind of like it just lifted.
Mm-hmm.
It just lifted. It just feels so much lighter.
Mm-hmm. And nothing I saw, I could see now because I used to do audio. But one thing I saw that the Lord was dispelling them out through the yarn. You know, that's one of the things.
Yes,
he used that a lot in my ministry. I remember the first time he used it, I was doing a video Skype session with a young lady from Cameroon, but she was living in the UK. And so when I was calling out spirit husband, it manifested, and I told her to come out. And she yawned. I never seen it before, so I said, wow, somebody didn't get much sleep last night, did they? Cause she was yawning. But then the Lord said, look at her yawn tear. Her mouth got so big. I said, oh God, that is not no regular yawn.
Mm-hmm.
You are casting demons out through the yawn. Her mouth got so wide and big. You know, the devil was coming out. Because she had her two little boys with her. And she was afraid of a manifestation. And the Lord showed her that he was compassionate. So he commanded those spirits come out through the yarn. And that's when the Lord said that would happen a lot in my ministry. Mm-hmm. When I call them out, a person will yawn. Especially when I do deliverance over the internet, they'll come out through the yarn. Now, when it's in person, it'd be a totally different case. They just pitch a fit a little bit. But mm-hmm. I don't allow them to pitch a fit a lot, you know. And they come on out. But God set you free. And you pray and you thank you. You're free. You are truly free indeed. Again,
Amen.
Now you continue with your self-deliverance in maintaining your freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Telling you. I'm telling you, because the devil lost you. He right now he's pitching a fit. We got to get her back. We got to get her back. There's a plan we have for her. The plan we have for her, so we need her back. So he's going to try everything in his power. If he had to try to show his ugly face, it would do that. But you don't have to tolerate that. You say no. You don't have to tolerate the devil manifesting in your faith. You say no in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, sick him! You know, let me explain what Holy Ghost sick him mean, because this young man, I'm telling you, dear heart, the devil is sneaky. He was saying the Holy Ghost sick him, fire prayer. I got a video on fire prayer. Holy Ghost took them. It's very effective and fervent in the spirit realm and casting spirit mm-hmm. out. And so he would begin to repeat after me, and hey, those demons was getting hot. They was getting hot, and they really had to do something to quiet him up because they didn't want to leave. So they lied in his hearing. In other words, that she telling you wrong, telling the Holy Ghost sick him. In other words, she calling the Holy Ghost a dog, because that's what we said, dog, sick him. A lot of time we use words we don't understand the meaning of that word. We just use it because we hear our mother or our father use it. Especially when you call it, you want a dog to attack, you say sick him. But you really don't understand the meaning of it. So anyway, he stopped. And so he sent me a kind of snobbish message over the internet telling me I had to repent for Holy Ghost sick him, you know, like that. And so, I mean, he sent on my YouTube video first, and then he found my page. And that's when I saw it, when he found my Facebook page. So I replied back to him. I said, you need to realize that the word sick him is a connotation. It's a connotation that means to seek and destroy. To seek and destroy. To seek with the intent to destroy. That's what sickle means. It's a connotation. It means to seek with an intent to destroy. Well, Isaiah 59:19 tells us that's what the Holy Ghost do. You know, the Holy Ghost comes in like, it's not the devil comes in like a flood, because I hear many theologians say the comma is in the wrong place. It's the Holy Spirit that comes in like a flood and lifts up that standard against the enemy.
Yes.
So he comes in like a pent-up stream. You know, when a stream is pent up, when you unpin that stream, wow, you're talking about the force of that water flowing. Watch out, it destroys everything in its path. But that's what the Holy Ghost do when we call upon him to come against darkness. Sick him. You see, with intent to destroy darkness.
Yes, definitely.
So I never did hear back from that young man, but he needs to be delivered. But you see how the devil tricked him and getting him to stop.
Yes.
See, because God wants to set him free through that prayer, but he listened to the devil.
Mm. Yes.
So now, Sister B, you continue to do your self-deliverance and maintaining your deliverance in Jesus' name, because you are totally free. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Anything else you want to say before we go?
No, other than I don't know if there's anybody else watching.
Oh, no. The initial session is just me and you. It's just me and you, God, and devil. We are the only one that's here.
Okay.
But when I post it, that's when people will see it.
So yes, you are going to post it?
Yeah, now. You should have saw that. I put that on everything. I said all sessions, all calls that I consider to be public. What makes them public is I'm going to share it. I record and share it on all my programs. And with the video Skype, I tell people it's not audio. I said the reason why is because I used to do just audio. I used to do private sessions. But then I said, Lord, these people are losing their deliverance. What is going on here? I mean, they didn't tell me they lost their deliverance. The Lord told me. I said, Lord, why are they losing their deliverance? He said, because they're ashamed. They're ashamed. They said, they'll share my goodness when I bless them financially. But as far as sharing my goodness, how I deliver, cast devils out of them, they are ashamed. So they want it public. They don't want it recorded. And as long as they're ashamed, they're sin. Because they're not willing to give up their person. They're not willing to give up their reputation. They hold on to their reputation. And that is ground for the enemy to return. I say, yes, Lord. So I stop. I start doing private sessions. And so that's why on everything I post, that all calls, all sessions with Evangelist King, they are considered to be public, they are recorded, and will be shared on all our programs. Okay? And you really should have saw that. You know, all I can do is share it, but I can't make y'all read it. But praise God you brought it up, because the enemy tried to get you to be ashamed. And once you ashamed me, guess what? It's coming back, but this time it's not coming back by itself.
Yeah, I understand. I know that, Russ.
And you know what I found? During these deliverance sessions, and seeing people lose their deliverance, I said, Lord, I come to see what is truly the worst. Lord said, the man latter state is worse than the first. I come to see what the worst is, be. The worst is he would never desire to be delivered again. Mm-hmm. I seen it too many times. Why? Because them devil tell you, you don't need to be delivered.
Yeah.
And that's a dangerous state to be in. It's when you feel that you don't need to be delivered. Regardless of who you are, you know, we are being delivered every day. Now, we're not having demons cast out of us every day because we're not in disobedience. But we are being delivered from something every day. Matter of fact, we live in this life and going towards our final deliverance. See, I'll be our final deliverance haven't taken place yet. Our final deliverance is when we get rid of this mortal body and get a body of immortality, just like Jesus. That's our final deliverance. And we're working towards that final deliverance, you see. So that's the word. You never desire to be delivered again. I've seen it too many times. Too many times. Be careful now. Again, the devil is subtle. He knows what tricks to use or tricks to pull out his bag for every individual. Don't receive his suggestions. You know, don't receive his suggestions. Say, no. God's just too good for me. I'm willing to give up my reputation and share with the world what he had done for me. I remember when he first, there's some things I'd done that I would plan on never telling nobody, just between me and God and the devil. I ain't want nobody else to know about that thing, not even my children. And I just, here I was serving the Lord and happy. But the Lord knew that was this thing that did not want people to know about. And one day the Lord said, Terry, I want you to share your testimony. And he put in my spirit what he wanted me to share, and that was the thing that I didn't want to tell nobody. I said, what? He said, yeah, share your testimony. Well, I had to make that choice. Do I love Jesus, or do I love myself, my reputation? So I made that choice. I said, forget it, reputation. I'm sharing what Jesus want me to share. And I shared it, and when I did, that thing was hurting me. As I was sharing it, it was hurting, the pain of sharing it. It was hurting me, but I kept on sharing it. I would share it again when he told me, and that's hurt. I like, it would just hurt. But I kept on doing it. And do you not know, matter of time, I shared it, the hurt was gone. Hurt and pain was gone. I share it now like it's nothing. And do you not know, when I shared that testimony, I don't know how many, but the Lord said, this ministry had reached so many people that I'm not even aware of. But thousands upon thousands of people have gotten delivered because of that testimony. And I said, Lord, that's the reason why the devil did not want me to tell it.
Yes.
Because they needed to hear that. You probably done heard it too and don't realize you done heard it. Right. You know, that's the reason why he's using me in this area. But I had to make that choice. I mean, I love Jesus. I said, Lord, I love you. I mean, he gave up his reputation, B. You're talking about God, the creator, coming down here serving the creation, taking on mere mortal flesh. Come on now, I think we don't really think on that matter, how Jesus gave up his reputation for us. But we want to hold on to our reputation. Our problem is we want to do wrong and dirt, and that dirt that we do, wrong we do, end up involving other people, misleading them. And then when God save us, we like, I don't want nobody to know about that. No, you need to tell it. You need to talk, or somebody need to hear it. The scripture said we overcome Satan not just by the blood of the Lamb, but also by the word of our testimony.
Yes.
We got to be willing to share. Have you seen many ministers? You would think they never went through anything because they'll never share. They'll never share what they're going through. They share about how God financially blessed them. but sharing about how them devils was in you and what them devils had you to do and Jesus Christ set you free. No, you share as the Holy Spirit leads you. But some never share anything. You think they were born holy and righteous. Nuh-uh. We got to give up that reputation, dear heart.
Mm-mm. Yes.
And I'm here to help you give up that reputation. And like I tell a few people, I said, look now, if you don't to abide by these guidelines and terms, I said, well then, feel free to let the Lord lead you to another helper. Just go on. Don't get mad with me. Just go on. Fine. Let the Lord lead you to another helper. Because they know God's not going to lead them to no other helper. Because he's a way to have to give up that reputation. And I did deliver some of this lawyer from New York. She got delivered. And a few months later, she wanted to come to the local fire deliverance meeting. So she sent me a message. Evangelist King, I want to know if I come to the meeting. Could you make sure you don't include me in the video? I said, oh, God, that devil. Now, I won't call her the devil. It was the devil playing that thought in her head. Mm-hmm. Oh, your colleague's going to see you, and they're going to talk about you. And she was ashamed. I replied back. I said, no. Didn't I tell you at Hogo's Fire Deliverance meeting, all meetings are public, recorded, shared on all our programs. Any request to edit you out will be denied. I said, you have to give up your reputation. You hold on to it, and the devil's going to hold on to you. And so she sent me another message. The Lord said, don't answer it. I didn't. 3 months later, she showed up at Hogo's Fire Deliverance meeting and got her deliverance.
Praise God.
And that would be called her total deliverance because it was partial because she was trying to hold on to her reputation. Yes. And she was happy she came. No, dear, I don't care what your status is in life. It don't matter if you're the president of the United States. Coming to Jesus, you have to give up that reputation. Give it up now. Can't be holding on to it. Nicodemus had to give up his. We have to give up ours. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So praise you are God. You are totally free, sister, in Jesus'
Thank
name.
Thank you so much for your time. Greatly appreciate
You're welcome. You're welcome. If you have any more questions, then it's best to send me an email. I'm trying to think what I'm going to do once I minister, deliver to individuals that ask for a video Skype session to avoid being interrupted. I'm going to end up removing your contact. That way, I don't have to worry about being interrupted when I'm in another session. And the person will say, well, Vance King online, so let me see if I can contact her. You understand what I'm saying? And I don't want that to happen because that's a distraction. So that's the reason why I said best thing to do is notify me through the email. Okay. Because, again, once I do the video Skype session, I'm going to remove the contact. So that I can avoid interruptions. Okay? Praise God.
Thank you, sister.
Now you again continue to maintain your deliverance in Christ Jesus until he comes. All right? Stay blessed.
Thank you. God bless you.
You too, sister. Shalom.
Shalom.